Matt's concert will be in the center, so it'll be functional seats. And I should say the composers have asked me to say that David Tudor and Jerry Collins have no way to endorse the concert. So I hope that Jane is.
Incompatible. something usually only accepted with some sometimes it's called degenerate or regenerative, but in any case, they generate new ideas and things, sounds.
Thank you.
all kinds of just some little things added, like an auxiliary power source and voltage regulator and this to jiggle things around and a place to plug it in and amplify it so I can play along with it. And since my hands are going to be busy playing the violin, I have to control it with my foot. And let's see. This Christmas card was given to me sometime shortly about the same time that I heard the news of Jerry Hunt's death. And the Christmas card was actually came from a friend of mine who didn't die the previous year in a jet crash in Portugal. It was like really amazing. She escaped with almost no scratch. And so it was a very special thing, sort of a reminder of basically about life and death. And the reason I'm using it is I was unpacking. I just moved into a new house, and it was the batteries had run down or something. It's making these sounds like, and I thought, oh God, I can relate to that. It sounds like actually, it sounded very much like the piece I had just begun improvising after I heard about Jerry's death and was just having a quiet evening at home, and I somehow, a slight accident happened in the piece that made me feel somehow there was a touch of Jerry in the air. And so actually, I had these sounds already, similar sounds produced before I heard this. And when I heard this, I really wanted to have it amplified and made into a functional musical instrument. And so here it is. Anyway, this is how the anklet looks, because there won't be a spotlight on it. Thank you.
became fascinated by his way of diagramming things, and also then realized, began to hear a lot of his sound-producing methods, which a lot of which are consist of feedback loops, electronic feedback loops, which don't have any acoustic input, but all the sound is generated by the activity of the electronics and the electronics feeding back in on itself. And in his work, done this way, a lot of his objectives were to achieve states where the system kind of took on a life of its own, or it was unpredictable and chaotic. And he did this with a table full of electronics, which is beautiful and theatrical. Then I came across an effects box, just a sort of average commercial device, which is in here, which had the similar components to the ones that Peter used, equalizers and phase shifters and typical modules, but it allowed you to connect them internally in any way that you like, including feedback loops. So I thought that was a way to start exploring some of Peter's ideas. And I don't think I'll say any more than that, but we have to answer questions, right?
Thank you.